How much?
About 30 million, Mr. Rourke.
30 million isk.
Yes, sir.
That's practically a new ship.
Clear Skies will practically be a new ship when she's fixed, sir.
But I don't want a new ship. I want this one back as it was.
There isn't, frankly, much left of the current vessel. Perhaps sir shouldn't have got it quite so badly damaged.
Hey, I didn't damage it. I wasn't the one shooting at it. Believe me, I was trying to avoid the damage.
Alas, sir, the damage didn't avoid you, and the repairs stand at 30 million isk.
Why don't I just strap an armour repair on and go clog up the outside of the station? That doesn't cost 30 million.
Sir, as I have explained already, it's not just the armour. Your superstructure is in dire need of reinforcing and renovation, as well as most of the internal systems.
Yeah, I know what you said. Still, at least if I'm paying that much, you'll have it ready fast, right?
3 weeks, sir.
How long?
Have they fixed it yet? Ooh, have they fixed it yet? Have they fixed it yet? Have they fixed it yet?
Try to quell your surprise, Charlie, but they have in fact finally finished welding Clear Skies back together. Jump up and clap hands with glee.
Oh, will miracles never cease?
It's hardly a miracle. They didn't take this long even after that Amarian slave trader shot the top wingy bit off a couple of years back.
Top wingy bit?
Well, hull breaches will do that to a ship's internal structure. Now, on to the more pressing matter of cash flow.
It's got a proper name, you know.
Yeah, the target.
Basically, we have no cash, and thus no flow.
So pretty much the last few years of grubbing around and getting our asses shot off has amounted to us sat here, bored to skin and with no charter. Champion, all we own is a ship that looks like an explosion in a girder factory.
Yeah, that and the tales to tell in the bars. Come on, you mustn't forget them. Anyway, with a fully refitted ship, we can look for a charter. And I've got good news and bad news on that front.
Oh, aye?
Yeah, the good news is I've got some idiot in a shiny suit. He wants ferrying 9 jumps across the fringes of Empire Space, and he only wants to go in a battleship-class vessel, which means we feature highly in his plans, especially as you don't normally get them docked around here. And he's also willing to pay 30 million quid.
How much?
For that kind of cash, he could buy his own ship.
Exactly, which brings us to the bad news.
Which is?
Some idiot in a shiny suit is willing to pay massively over the odds to get ferried 9 jumps through Empire Space and apparently needs a battleship to do it, which can only mean one thing.
It's a death trap.
It's a death trap.
So what else is there available?
Some job-shifting cans of quaff about in system for not enough money to even charge the capacitor, and that really is it. Seems like we picked the worst place to hold up in 10 jumps, but what with the ship's lack of ability to hold air in at the time, I guess we can't complain. Face it, lads, we don't really have a lot of choice. Either sell Clear Skies and go back to a cruiser, try and work our way back up again like the bad old days, or take on the death trap job.
We've only just had this ship put back into one piece. Paint isn't dry yet. I don't want to scratch the moment we undock, okay?
I'll take that as a vote for the trap of death. Charlie?
Oh, I'm gunnery. I don't care. Probably means that once again I'll be justifying my place on board.
What, you mean like the last time? How quickly we forget.
Right, sorted then. I'll contact the shiny suited idiot and tell him he's got a place on our ship. Then I'll check the insurance. Yes, sir.
Since when have we ever had insurance?
Since when indeed?
Okay, I've discussed it with my crew, and I'm happy to say you've got a place on our ship, Mr...
You can call me Mr. Smith.
Huh, and here we are, thousands of years down the line since Eve Day 1, and yet people still use Mr. Smith when wishing to remain anonymous.
Possibly I use it because that is my name.
Yeah, well, as long as the fund's clear, you can call yourself Eleanor Gatsky as far as I'm concerned.
The funds will clear. Half now, half on arrival. Standard Metropolis contract terms.
Assuming we make it, in fact. What's the destination?
The system of Heck, unfortunately.
Okay, Sol, you got that?
Yep. Heck, you say? Right, let's have a shafty. Hedion, Hemen... Ah, Heck, there it is. Looks like it's about 10 jumps from here. That's about an hour.
Excellent. Can we leave right away?
Sure, I can't see why not.
You have a sofa on the bridge of a ship. That's very eccentric.
Yeah, well, this ship's pretty much my home, and I'm not one for holing up in cabins. I like to sit out here and look at the stars.
Ah, someone holed up in an office for most of the time. I can understand that.
If you like the sofa that much, you can have it in your office for 200.
Hey, what have I
told you before about trying to sell my sofa, Burke?
You're right. You can have it for nothing.
Alas, my office is far too small for such an artifact. And on that note, gentlemen, I shall retire to my cabin and take some medication. Warp drive does affect my stomach, so, and I prefer to sleep through it.
Righto, let's get undocked and see what bits fall off the ship.
Clear skies, this is Station CNC. You are go for undock and warp.
Roger that, CNC.
And I'll see you later in the contract pages.
You got it, John. Try and bring it back intact next time. Station out.
That's odd. Yeah, everything looks sort of... Oh, they must have cleaned the windows or something.
They are undocked. The cargo is on board. They're on their way to you.
You know, I just don't know why Smith has a problem. I mean, how can gate travel upset you strongly?
So, to my surprise, everything's working first go.
That's a first.
Yeah, looks like these repairs were money well spent and they took the time commissioning it all correctly. You should remember the place that did this. Except, of course, the light above my console's flickering.
I thought you said everything was working first go.
Well, the major systems, yes, but we've still got dodgy lights, wiring, plumbing,
door motors, lift controls, the sink is backing up, and don't ask what happened to Sol in the shower. We've routed that lubricant line correctly now.
Yeah, but to be fair, it was like that before we got shot at.
It was like that before we bought it. It's Minmatar.
So, how are we stacked out then, in case anything, you know, goes wrong?
Well, I've got a torch.
No, I mean, if we get attacked, not if your console light goes out.
Ah, well, the shield's pretty good. I've spec'd out a good all-round system that is strong against most types of attack. We've got emergency boosters to reinforce it if we need to. The speed's pretty good, and I managed to fit some top-line trackers and stabilisers for the guns.
Oh, speaking of which, did they have your favourites?
Oh yeah, take a look. Top-of-the-line 1400mm howitzers. Biggest damn things we can strap on. Takes a while to cycle the action, but the range and stopping power is second to none. Most things tend to get the message when their shields fail after only one volley.
We never do.
Yeah, well, true. But unless you start specialising in one job, this is the best multi-role setup I've ever found for this ship. And I've noticed we don't tend to specialise.
Did you get any of that ammo you were on about?
The tremor stuff? Oh yeah, imported from Jitter, and this is some of my favourites. Doubles the range and hits hard. Only trouble is it weighs a goddamn much. It's almost faster to turn the ship than the guns. To be used on stationary targets only, I'm afraid.
Ah, my favourite kind.
You expecting targets, then?
I always expect targets. You should always expect targets. Your gunnery.
Yeah. Trouble is, JR, as ever, it gets more difficult to prepare for all the possibilities out there. The universe has changed since we started, and the number of specialised ships just keeps on increasing. You know I can't cover all eventualities with a one-on-one engagement these days.
I know that. I just ask you to prepare the best we can.
Okay, and what if it's multiple targets? It usually is. When was the last time you saw just one ship at a gate?
Look, Charlie, I know where this is going, so just forget about it.
I'm just saying that in this day and age, it's usually better to have, well, some backup.
We've got backup. What about Cormark? What about Haffa, huh?
They aren't really backup, JR. They're just some strange people we know. They aren't ever even in the same system, so even if they do respond, we have to wait for them to show up.
And they always do?
Eventually. Sometimes we need backup there and then. Cast your mind back to about 3 weeks ago. We nearly died, Johnny.
Yeah, I know what happened, Charlie. I was there, remember?
And here we are, skint, with a highly suspicious job on and no backup. Again.
Oh, so this is going back to signing up for a corporation now, is it, huh? Some faceless bunch of idiots who spend the whole time bickering before screwing you over for every isk you've got. And when they say jump, you have to jump because they own your ass.
At the moment, John, when you say jump, we have to jump or it is our ass. In a corp, you get a paycheck, some security and stability, and a whole corporate fleet behind you when the going gets tough. Big difference. And for all the freedom you talk about in this crew, it's gotten us chained to a dangerous operation that we can't refuse because we never have any goddamn money.
Hey, Charlie, if you don't like it, why don't you just sign up with Kaldari Provisions and stack shelves for a living, eh?
It's a good job someone's paying attention to the damn scanner for the last five jumps because, ladies, at this gate is a very suspicious formation of ships waiting for us. I suggest you come to the bridge. Quick!
What you got, Salt?
One missile boat damage dealer, Raven-class battleship, supported by Blackbird EW and attack the frigate.
Damn it, that's a setup.
You're right, it's getting worse. The gate guns are offline and the local channel is clear of anyone but us four. Whoever these guys are, they've got some influence.
They have confidence too. That's not the biggest gate camp I've ever seen.
Confidence or secrecy, this smells of a black op. You've got low numbers and nasty people who are keeping their mouths shut.
Nasty people who are locking us up too.
Right, so get to engineering, start warming up the warp drive. Put us on alignment for nearest gravity where we can target. I don't care what it is. Chart safe spot en route and prep for a double back. You know the drill. Charlie, get to gunnery and look lively. Bounce a lock back to them and take the safeties off the 1400s. We may need to distract them while they withdraw.
Ain't no better distraction than that.
Lining up on planet 4.
Safety's off, locking up all three hostiles.
Ah, damn it. That type of stuck a graviton beam straight to the warp core, John. It's hit the limiters and have gone offline. We didn't get the speed in time.
We aren't going to hit him with these guns either. It's way too small and fast.
In that case, focus on that blackbird before...
I've lost lock. We're jammed.
Cycle time.
10 seconds, but it's off the scale. Our sensors are swamped. No chance of punching through it. It'll catch us every cycle.
Not that it really matters, lads. I'm picking up a local distortion field building up as well.
Is it a Weber?
Yep, and there it is. We can push about 20 metres a second now, and that's your lot. We ain't going anywhere.
And we're not shooting back either. Now what?
Oh, well, now I'll make a call to our backup.
It's a sad reflection on our lifestyle when you got a pre-recorded message begging for help. The Raven captain's opening up comms with us.
Put him on.
John Rourke.
Well, clearly I'm more famous than you, mate, because I don't know your name.
I'll make this simple just for you. Hand over your cargo or die.
Huh, you know, Quaife isn't that expensive in the shops, and 300 cubic metres of the stuff's going to rot your teeth as well.
What are you talking about?
My cargo. It's Quaife. You know, the popular drink sold in all stations in your region.
Obviously, I didn't make things simple enough. We know you have a Mr. Smith on board. Hand him over or you die.
Oh, Mr. Smith. Right. Why exactly do you want him badly enough to shut down a whole system and threaten us?
That's not your concern.
It's certainly not the concern of a frozen corpse either. And I don't care which particular unconcerned thing I leave him awake. Now give me Smith.
But Mr. Smith's been with us for years.
What?
My cuddly toy mascot bear, Mr. Smith. He's been on the ship for years. He brings us luck, although I'm beginning to suspect I should check which type.
I think you've upset him.
I know you've upset him.
The way he disconnected in a sulk?
Nope, the way he launched torpedoes at us.
Well, that's just plain rude. What's your assessment, Charlie?
They're hitting us with old-school explosives, and a lot of them, which is a shame as the shields are tuned. Reflect and rebound, not stop pressure waves.
Damn it. How are our shields holding out, Salt?
Kind of stressed they are.
I'm boosting them off storage, but it's not going to last forever.
Have you spun up the hardness?
Of course I have. It's making a difference, but not enough of one.
Are we going to tank it or not?
Tank it? Hardly. They'll be down in 2 minutes of this. It's a different level of abuse.
2 minutes? Are you sure?
Of course I am. The shockwaves are already starting to affect the armour plating. The shields are down to 20%. Stop asking the stupid questions and start getting us the hell out of here.
Goodbye, Mr. Smith. Or whoever you are.
Sat doing nothing here. Sol, can you please get tracking back online?
Look, I'm having a hard enough time trying to keep the ship intact, thanks. And anyway, no, we haven't got sensor boosters.
JR, we may as well throw these 40 punches at them for all the goddamn good they're doing. Where the hell is our so-called backup?
That's what I'd like to know. The shields are just about... No, mate, that they're down.
Come on, Cor, come on.
Shields are down, Rourke. Shields are down. I bet you're not so smug now while your Matari bucket of bolts falls apart around you. Keep firing.
The armor's half gone, and I'm starting to pick up hull beats across the ship. 7 minutes remaining, I'm starting to lose control functions.
We've got a signal on the local channel. This should be our backup.
It is damn better, be the left behind us just went offline.
That makes our hull look like tinfoil. That's bad.
No, what's bad is that next torpedo seems to be coming my way.
That one's coming through the wall. Run!
I'm way ahead of you. Well, how's my exercise done for the week?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'll head to engineering.
I've got the shields back up to 5%, but that's your lot. The cap's dead.
You alright, lads? You having some problems?
Take that damn heron out, Cor. He's got us locked down big time. We need to get out of here while we've still got a ship to get out.
What? No? Hello? No? How are you?
Shut up and hurry up. We're in bad shape here.
Yeah. I'm already on it.
Who the hell's this? We weren't told he had backup. Is this just some local chancer?
Okay, lads, he's down. Light your fire and go.
Warp core has just moved out and navigation is back online. I'm winding up the coils now.
Good. Bounce us off the planet, get us somewhere safe. Then we see about fixing the damn ship again.
I'll go get the dustpan and brush.
Fully fixed. It was fully fixed. Better than ever. And now, almost instantly, it's wrecked again. I knew it was going to be a trap, but I didn't expect a whole system to be locked down. Who do they think they are?
And why are they so interested in Smith? To go all that trouble and actually try and get the guy alive? Maybe we should just pop him out in a cargo pod.
We'll not get another charter in this region if we fold up like that, and you know it. Is he even still alive after all that?
Yeah, his life signs are fine. Those pills he took must be potent. He's still asleep. Want me to go wake him up?
No, don't bother. He'll either wake up at the station and give us the cash or he'll never wake up again along with the rest of us. Anyway, he doesn't strike me as the type to stay calm in this sort of situation, and the last thing we need is
some suit panicking.
Well, our partner is a course that will backtrack us to the station we came from. I'm hoping they haven't got the durometer gate covered, otherwise we're in big trouble.
Durometer gate? The hell with that? We're finishing this job.
How can we do that?
Set a course for Amori.
We can't get there without going through that gate.
Set us a course for Amori.
And that'll just get us killed, so forget it,
we're
John.
Going through this system, that gate.
In what? A tractor
being
wrecked?
And we're going through them if they get in the way again.
Oh, well, that's a well thought out plan.
So, not only do we now need the cash more than ever, but we do not run away. You know that, and I know that. Besides, they took chunks out of our ship, Sol. We got to make them pay for that.
Yeah, true, but exactly how do we do that now that we've only got half a ship? They kicked their ass when we had a whole one. The jammer's still there, so we won't be able to fire. What are we going to do? Shout at them?
Charlie, do the guns still work?
Well, yeah, they should do, seeing as they haven't been fired yet. All the gunnery systems are green. Ish.
Then we'll have everything we need.
What? This wrecking an interceptor? I've got to agree with Solomon. Even if we could fire our guns, that completely intact and undamaged battleship will rip us apart.
Charles, that battleship will have a surprise coming that is going to work out in our favour. I've got more than one pre-recorded message begging for help.
Eeny? Meeny? Miney? Damn it!
Right, he's on his way. You guys get whatever repairs that need doing done and make it fast.
I guess I'll start up that massive hole in what used to be the bridge. Anything else? Maybe clean the windows again?
Just sort out enough stuff to get us up to combat readiness. I'll go check over the rest of the ship.
Right, okay, fine. Combat readiness? That's a laugh.
Need a hand?
Can do. I can't believe we're going back.
He's not happy. I prefer the nice and happy JR, not the angry one. Left a bit.
Idiot's gonna get us killed. Get us combat worthy? Yeah, okay then. I'll swap the ship for Titan. That should do it.
Well, if anyone can fix it, it's Solomon, 25 years in the Caldari Navy, Burke.
23 and a half, and don't try to flatter me, Fodder. You know it doesn't work. Aren't you concerned about this at all?
What? Your ability to remote control a robot carrying an 800mm thick plate of steel? No, not at all.
No, the whole getting killed as a point of honour we don't run thing.
Nah, you know me. How bad is all this anyway? We got power for the guns?
The capacitor's damaged and it's charging slow even if the extra cable runs bodged in. Your guns don't use it though, so they'll keep firing until they fall off the ship. The armor's pretty much gone, and I've got the shields back up to full power. It's a tough ship, but it's still not good. Whoever this help is, they'd better be on time and useful.
In a situation like this, the help's probably going to be Haffa.
Oh great, help from someone who scares me.
Well, at least he'll help keep both the top and bottom wingy bits on. That's got to count for something.
Do you want me to weld the cabin doors shut with this thing? Because I can, you know. How many times have I got to tell you those parts of a ship have a correct name?
Well?
Sir, no report of any Minotaur-class battleships at the other gate.
Have we got a scan probe ship available?
No, sir. That wasn't part of our tactical package.
Neither were his reinforcements. Very well, we'll play the waiting game. That heap of Rourke's is already leaking air, so I don't anticipate much of a problem whether he decides to run or fight.
Okay, JR, your control functions are patched into the console that hasn't been blown up. The capacitor's charging about as fast as it's going to without a dock refit, and most of the red lights are out on other systems.
Nice one, Sol.
Bear it in mind, our armour's pretty much gone, although I've got the binders back online, so at least I'll stop the hull breaches like the last one. Well, for a bit.
Gotcha.
Based on the tacticals from the last fight, we've got about 2 minutes for our shields to the deck. You reckon we can take them down before then? Our armour will fold up at the first real sign of abuse.
I intend on having as long as I like to take him out. Don't you worry. Right, Cormark, you ready?
Yep, as always.
Your target
is... The Blackbird. Yeah, I'm on it.
Good.
Are you sure about this?
Very. Get to your stations. Gang warp us in.
Cormark, we're going into gang warp now.
Charlie?
Yeah?
You know that expensive ammo you spent a week in Jeddah waiting for?
Yeah.
Time to use it.
Oh yeah.
Sir, we are picking up a warp signature in this vicinity.
Surely he isn't going to face us again.
No messing this time, Charlie. Lock him up and fire everything we own as quick as you can. Salt, disable the thermal cutoffs on everything.
Overheat him if you have to.
Locking up in 3, 2, 1, firing.
Sir, they are firing some sort of exotic ammunition at us.
Really? Well, fire some of our non-exotic missiles back.
Still achieving lock, sir. 8 seconds.
Why isn't our jammer stopping them?
Cool, how you doing?
Me? I'm having a ball. That Blackbird pilot is in such a panic, he's forgotten the jammer he wants. It's made of old Quaken, so it shouldn't take too long.
Blackbird pilot is requesting permission to leave the battle. He's receiving structural damage.
Ignore that, Aegis. How much damage are we taking because that fool can't do this one job?
Shields will last another minute at this rate of fire, sir.
Sir, the controller at the barometer gate has reported a local beacon activating, but no corresponding gate activation and there is no response.
Does it look like I can? My traffic report, Jimbo. Just keep firing.
JR, the jammer's down, but my guns are dry. I wouldn't scratch that Raven anyway, so I'm out of here.
Yeah, thanks, Cor. I owe you one.
Oh, yeah, don't worry about it. I'll bill you for it. But fly safe. Well, yeah, okay. You know what I mean. Fly safe once people have stopped hurling missiles at them.
I'll see you in station.
Well, that's great news, JR. But our shields aren't going to last much longer.
Tactical shows that we're going to be in armour before that Raven will be. He's got a full complement. Thought we could take as long as we'd like.
Shields are down again, Rourke, and this time your armour won't...
Sir?
Save. What in Divinity's Edge? What the hell is that?
Sir, it's targeted us and,
And unleash an experimental electronic warfare. Somebody up top underestimated these people.
Ceasefire, Charlie. Let's see what he has to say now.
I heard about these next generation chips, but I didn't think they were in active military use yet.
Never mind in the general population.
They aren't. It's stolen. So, you want to tell me what this was all about while you still can?
You don't know who you're messing with. This is too big for some privateer nobody. Next time there'll be a fleet waiting for you and no amount of cloaker freaks will pull you out of the fire, Rourke.
Oh, that's mighty big talk from someone locked down by a cloaker freak and locked up by a privateer nobody.
You'll find out about Smith one way or the other, and it's going to go hard on you. I'll let my superiors know that you chose poorly.
Your superiors aren't going to hear anything about this, especially not from you.
It'll go better for you if you let me go.
Yeah, I really don't think I can believe that.
Because, let me see, it would involve trusting someone who just tried to kill me and my crew twice.
Don't worry, I won't be trying a third time.
I'll be lucky to have a cleaning job after this disaster.
Ah, but I must now consider you a mortal enemy because you took it upon yourself to attack me and mine. This ends now, no matter what you say.
Don't be ridiculous, this was a paid job.
No matter what you say, there is only one way to make sure I and my crew can sleep sound at night now, and it's your fault I have to do it.
Wait, there's no...
All guns, fire.
No!
Well, thanks for your help, Haffa.
Are we even yet?
No.
Yeah, whatever.
Well, that was awkward.
What exactly is it between those two?
They were friends once. I think I helped them pinch that freaky ship.
What? RJR?
Yeah, funny to think, eh? I think something went wrong in the raid, though, because Haffa always says that "are we even yet" thing.
Even for what?
Dunno. Don't want to know.
Okay, let's see if we can finish this run without hitting any more trouble, shall we?
So will the engine start, or shall I get out and push?
Station, I hope you've got space in your dock for one ship and your bar for three people.
That's an affirmative, Clear Skies, although it only looks like half a ship to us.
Yeah, yeah, tow us in and send me the contract pages. I need another job to pay for this one.
Okay, sir. Dock port 3 is open.
Well, I guess that's another tale to tell in the bars, eh?
Ah, are we there? I feel quite refreshed.
Oh, so you slept okay then?
Oh yes. I'm sure I started this journey on a complete battleship.
Yeah, and I'm sure I started this journey as a transport job.
Meaning?
Meaning you didn't pay us for escort duty, and you knew there would be trouble.
I would have thought the rather generous payoff should have hinted towards it being somewhat non-standard charter.
You could have warned us exactly how much trouble was waiting for us. Your ass was on the line as well, you know.
Mr. Rourke, I assure you I had no idea what was waiting for us. I didn't expect it to be so organised.
Ah, so you knew it was organised. I thought you slept through it all, hmm?
In my line, Mr. Rourke, one learns to be a very light sleeper. Your funds have been transferred. I look forward to doing business with you again.
I don't think so, Mr. Smith. Those people were connected up harder than I ever want to see.
Oh, Mr. Rourke, don't misunderstand me. That was a statement, not a question or a request. Those were not the only people connected up high, and there are difficult times ahead. Yes, indeed, difficult times for everyone.
Yeah, well, we aren't everyone. Well, we're undocking after only 2 weeks this time.
So now what? The cash we've got only just covers the repairs, again, and yet another job hauling quaves just to charge the cap.
Yeah, we seem to keep going in circles here. Never have any cash left over. What's the point?
Well, we've got the adventure. There are a lot of people that are envious of that, you know.
I envy people that've got money left over after they've repaired their ship.
Well, I've got nowhere else to go, so here I am.
So we're stuck with you, no matter how many times JR tries to get us killed.
Oi, Charlie, we're still here, aren't we? You know, there's always tomorrow.
No, I don't know. What that Mr. Smith said about us seeing him again. Can't help but feel there's a big cloud on the horizon.
No, you're worrying too much. No clouds on this horizon. We've got clear skies.
Won't you tell me something true?